What's going on, YouTube? This is Sehaman back with another figure review. We're actually back with another Walking Dead figure review. This is the last figure from the series, besides the non-variant Rick Grimes. I haven't reviewed that one yet, but this is pretty much the last figure of the series. This is that I'm going to be reviewing. This is the Zombie Biter. We'll go ahead and take a close look at the package before we look at the figure. So here's the packaging. Same as the other ones. You got Rick Grimes. There's the Zombie Biter we're going to be reviewing, who comes with Biting Action Jaw and Deer Meat. Daryl Dixon and Zombie Walker. The front's the same packaging as the others. Set this down, and let's get a close look. So this is actually a decent looking figure. You can see his eyes are looking off to the side. It's got nice detail in the face. Let me lift the camera up a little more. Alright, sorry about that. So he's got nice detailing on the face. If you can see his eyes, he is looking off to the side. He's got a lot of detail in the shirt. There's a little button for the gimmick that I'm going to show you in a second. So he's got some blood stains in the back of the shirt. He's got blood all over his hands. But I really do think the face is nicely detailed. You can see his lips are like eaten away. So all you see is pretty much teeth. He's got a scar right here on the top of his head, forehead. Yeah, I really do like the zombie figure. Get a look at the shoes. Got some dirty shoes. Now, if you guys don't remember this zombie from the show, this is where he was eating the deer meat. Let's see here, the tie, a little plastic, soft plastic, some blood there on the shirt. So his accessory that he comes with is actually some deer meat. What it is exactly, I don't know like what part it is, but he just comes with some deer meat. Looks like this might be some fur here. So that's pretty much it. Now his gimmick. Okay, so if you look closely in his mouth, you can see he's got a little line going across his jaw. On both sides. So what you do is just push this button in the back, and this is the gimmick. You can see his tongue there. Get a side view of that. This gimmick is actually a lot cooler than the zombie walker that with the wind-up action. So you can see the buttons there. So I don't know, tell me what you guys think in the comments below about this figure. Do you like the gimmick? Do you think the figure itself looks cool? And are you guys overall happy with the series? So if you guys can let me know in the comments below, give me your opinion. And which one was your favorite out of the four? Now in the way of this zombie's articulation, he does have, let's see, his arms do go in and out, forward and back. He can bend at the elbow. He does have waist articulation, so he rotates. The head cannot rotate due to the gimmick. His foot has like a little swivel in it, not much. But it can't go up and down actually. Yep, a bend at the knee on both legs and a swivel at the leg. Show you that biting action one more time. Actually really like that. Okay, that's my review for the last zombie from The Walking Dead, the TV series. And this is by McFarlane Toys, and this is Seha Man. So hope you guys enjoyed my review, and we'll see you guys soon.